Myself Geeta Priya. I did my naval architecture in IMU, currently working in Amit University as the assistant professor in naval architecture and offshore engineering department. Now I'm going to present a video lecture on a course, lifting surfaces for marine applications. In that I'm going to cover the topic blade element theory, which is the part of the propeller theories, which has composed of four theories. Before getting into the theory, first, I would like to explain how the thrust is producing, how the mechanism is happening. The thrust which is used to propel the ship, which is used to move the ship forward, the propeller accelerates the water passing through it. By the way, the thrust is produced. This is what I have shown in the PPT. See, you can see the thrust which is happening in the direction of the ship, and flow is happening opposite to the propeller, and propeller rotates, thereby water gets accelerated. Okay, now we gonna talk about the, I'm gonna talk about propeller theories. Why, first question is why we need to study propeller theories. The propeller theories are derived initially, and why it, which gives the results which help us to understand the action of the propeller, the fundamental propeller actions, and also which gives the results which is useful for us to design a propeller with a good efficiency. And it also says that if all the radial sections has the same efficiency, you can design a propeller with most efficient. And it also gives detailed geometry of the propeller for a optimum performance condition at a given time. When we talk about the propeller theories, there are four propeller theories. One is axial momentum theory, and the another one is impulse theory, and the third one is blade element theory, and the fourth one is circulation theory. Here we are going to concentrate more on blade element theory. Still, I will give a brief notes on propeller axial momentum theory and as well as impulse theory. The first theory is axial momentum theory, which we can also call actuator disc theory. Here we are considering a propeller as a circular disc. This is the first assumption we are making in this theory, and the concept of this theory is the water passing through the propeller is accelerated by the propeller, which is, we can simplified manner we can say like the propeller is imparting a sudden increase of pressure. And in this theory, this is the theory which is derived at the early stages, and in this theory they didn't specify how the pressure is increased. They kept a word like it's an unspecified mechanism. So what are the main assumptions we are taking in axial momentum theory is, first one, we are considering it as a circular disc, and another one, there is unlimited flow of water to the propeller, and the third one is the pressure increase due to the propeller is an unknown mechanism. So I am not going detailedly into the derivation of this theory. Directly I am going to the result of this theory. What we are arriving at this theory is, we are getting a ideal efficiency which is equal to 1, and as you know, the ideal efficiency 1 is not possible. Since why we are getting the ideal efficiency is because the frictional losses, we are considering only the frictional losses of the propeller due to the when the water flows onto the propeller. There is some other losses like we can say eddy losses and due to the viscous force, we are not considering that, and which gives the ideal efficiency in this theory. And one more thing, as in this theory, it is if the upstream velocity and the downstream velocity of a foil is equal, then there will be no thrust only, but there will be no thrust will be produced. In that case, you will have the ideal efficiency, which is equal to 1. In the previous theory, we have discussed only the axial flow, since we can call that as axial momentum theory. Here we are talking about the impulse theory. What is the difference between the previous theory and this theory is, in impulse theory we are considering both axial as well as the rotational. Since when we are talking about axial, the force what we acquire is thrust. When we talk about the rotational, the tangential force, which is nothing but torque. So what this theory will be giving is the efficiency is equal to dt by dq, which is thrust by torque. And here what is the result of this theory is, it will give the relation between axial and rotational velocities when friction is neglected. So this is what the major difference between these two theories. In the previous two theories, we have considered propeller as a disc. This blade element theory is very unique because we are considering a blade of the propeller, we are considering the blade of the propeller, and also we are taking an element in the propeller blade. Here what we are getting a axial component as well as the tangential component. Since you know axial component is nothing but the thrust, and tangential component is torque. Here what we, why we do blade element theory means, from the element, in an element we can get the axial force, which is thrust dt, and the tangential force, which is torque dq, for a single element. And if we integrate over the radius of the propeller, we will get the overall thrust and torque produced by the propeller. This is why we are doing this blade element theory, and it will be very useful in designing your propeller with more efficiency. Here I have given the diagram for the force diagram. First we are considering one condition, which is without induced velocities. I'll tell you what is induced velocity. So I'll be drawing detailly to give the diagram. I'll be drawing this here. As I said, we are taking the blade element. So from here we are taking the blade element. The radius from here to here, it is r. This is dr. Okay, so I'm going to draw the force diagram. Force diagram, if you consider, take a foil section. Since I told we are taking the element of the propeller blade, I'll be taking the foil section, and the tangential velocity is in this way, and the axial means in a longitudinal direction. So your tangential velocity, this is your tangential velocity 2 pi n r. By 2 pi n r means, tangential means omega into r, omega is equal to 2 pi n. So here 2 pi n r, and this is your axial velocity, which is v a. So we are having our tangential velocity and our axial velocity. Our resultant velocity will be here, which is v r, and here it will be the angle of attack. Then the at which angle the we are getting the resultant velocity is our beta. And one more thing I forgot to tell is the pitch angle. To say what is the pitch angle, I have to tell you, If you consider a blade like this, a element of the a blade section will not be in the same plane, it will be at some angle. So that angle we will call as pitch angle, and which is denoted by angle pi. So this will be your pitch angle pi. This we are getting without induced velocity. Since we are having two velocities, the resultant force, you know, the lift will be generated perpendicular to the foil, and the drag will be generated in the direction of the flow, which is the opposing force. So you will get a drag here and you will get a lift in a perpendicular direction. So you know the lift force is a thrust. So you will be getting resultant thrust here. Since I am taking only the element, I am making it as dt, and we are taking, we have to integrate for all the blades. So I am dividing it by z, means I am denoting the letter z, which is number of blades. So dt by z. Here the same way the drag component will get, which is nothing but our torque. Here I am going to put the same way dq by z, which is number of blades. And since we are talking about the angular velocity, we have to divide it, we have to take the moment. So I am dividing it by r. So this is what the, without induced velocity, this is what your force diagram will be. So as I shown in the diagram, we are taking a number of blades denoted by z, and the blade element is r plus dr. So the thing is, we have to take the lift and the drags. So as you know, the lift coefficient will be CL is equal to L by half rho AB square, and CD will be same, replacing L with D. So we are having the lift coefficient and also the drag coefficient. Now what we are going to do here is, from the force diagram you can get the DL and DD, which is the elemental lift and elemental drag. With that we can calculate our CL and CD, and our efficiency will be calculated. Since you know the beta needs to be calculated by, beta is equal to tan inverse of VA by 2 pi NR, and we will be calculating the what is the efficiency without considering the induced velocities. So without induced velocity, what is the efficiency we are arriving at is, efficiency eta is equal to tan beta divided by tan beta plus gamma. So here when we talk about the ideal efficiency, eta is equal to 1. For a blade element having the ideal efficiency 1, and the same efficient if the, which will occur in no drag condition, and all the blade elements will have the same efficiency, which is very much controversial statement to the axial momentum theory and impulse theory what we have discussed before. So where we are missing, why it is ideal efficiency 1 is not possible to achieve, and what we are missing is the induced velocity. So we will see what is induced velocity. So what we are talking about is induced velocity. What is induced velocity means, the velocity induced by the action of the propeller. Due to the propeller action, our tangential velocity, which is in this direction, and the axial velocity, which is will be in the longitudinal direction, will have a change. So what is the change is, due to the propeller action, our tangential velocity will be reduced, and our axial velocity, which is VA, will be increased. So the decrement in the tangential velocity will be given by A dash, and the incremental value of the axial velocity will be given by A. So this incremental and decremental in the velocities due to the propeller action we have to consider. So which will have a impact in the result, which is nothing but our efficiency. So we will see what is the impact we are getting in the efficiency of the propeller when we are considering with induced velocities, which is VA into A, and 2 pi in a tangential velocity, it is 2 pi nr into A dash. So, we are going to draw the force diagram with considering our induced velocities. So, we will be having our foil and there will be an angle of attack which is alpha, and you will be having your tangential velocity which previously told us 2 pi nr. Now, here we will be having your axial velocity which is Va. As I told you, there is a decrement in the tangential velocity. So, there is a decrement and which is denoted with A dash. So, A dash 2 pi nr, and here this is your resultant velocity Vr. Here it is a increment. So, it will be increased and you will get another resultant velocity. This is a Va. That increment we are denoting with a factor A. So, as I told you, with the initial resultant velocity without considering the induced velocity, we got beta. After considering the induced velocities, the angle which makes with resultant velocity is beta dash. So, and we have to mention our pitch angle, which will be from here to here. The same way, the drag will be created and the lift will be created in your perpendicular direction. You will get a torque which is 1 by r z into dq. Here you will be getting your thrust which is dt by z. This is what the difference you will be acquiring when you consider the induced velocities, which is due to the propeller action. Which is due to the propeller action had an impact on the tangential force and as well as your axial forces. So, after considering the induced velocities, what is the efficiency we are arriving at is efficiency eta is equal to tan beta divided by the previous efficiency is tan eta is equal to tan beta divided by tan beta plus gamma. After we are considering the induced velocities, what is the efficiency we are arriving at is tan beta is equal to 1 plus a divided by 1 minus a dash tan beta. 1 plus a is for the tangential, for the axial force, and 1 minus a dash is for the rotational forces, which is your tangential force, and we are considering the induced velocity. So, the ultimate aim of the theory is to use the practical use of it. So, when we need to apply practically the blade element theory, means we have to know our CL which is lift coefficient, our CD which is drag coefficient, and A which is incremental value due to the propeller action in the axial flow, and A dash which is a decremental value to the tangential force. So, we need to know CL, CD, A and A dash for design the propeller using the blade element theory in a most efficient way. And this CL and CD will be obtained by the experimental data. So, far we have discussed three theories: axial momentum theory and our impulse theory and blade element theory. These theories are useful in a way we can understand the fundamental action of the propeller, so that we can able to know where we can play in the design to get the most efficient propeller. And also it is useful in the design of the propeller. As I said, we can able to know where which parameter, if we change which parameter, what will be the impact on the thrust created by the propeller. Our ultimate aim is to give less power and acquire more thrust. So many innovation projects are going on in optimizing the propeller design. For optimizations, And for designing, we need to understand the propeller theory properly. And this propeller theory says that if a radial section of the propeller has a good efficiency, if the same efficiency is there for all the radial sections, then that propeller will be considered as most efficient. That is what we have seen in our blade element theory, that compared to the previous two theories, the blade element theory is more apt for the practical use. We can design a better element, since don't complicate with the overall blade. We can design a good element and try to apply for the all the elements to get more efficiency. And also it from the theories we can get the geometry of the propeller, how we design the geometry of the propeller for the optimum performance in a given operating conditions. It will be how it will be performing in a more efficient way. Thank you.